Ellie with WCTM, and today I'm talking with Anisa Khadraoui from the Abyssinian Meeting House. Thank you so much for joining us today, Anisa.
No problem. Glad to be here.
Where is the Abyssinian Meeting House, and what is the building like?
So the Abyssinian Meeting House is located on Newbury Street in Portland, and it's nearly 200 years old, so it's a very old and historical building that's in the process of being restored. So it's hard to explain what the building is like until you've seen it, but it's incredibly beautiful, and it's just a real gem, I think, in Portland's crown.
That's so cool. Why is the AMH important to Maine history and national history?
Sure, I think Black history is American history. And Maine in general plays a very important role in the Black diaspora. And because Maine was one of the last stops en route to Canada on the Underground Railroad. And so the Abyssinian Meeting House in particular was a place that abolitionists spoke and preachers spoke. And it was one of the only schools, one of five schools in the country where Black children were educated. And so it's such an important part of not only Maine's history and America's history, but everyone's history. And it's just critically important for everyone to know what our history is.
That's really inspiring. So I hear you guys are currently in the midst of a major restoration project. What does that entail for the building?
So that entails understanding where the building started and how it got to where it is. It also entails major fundraising efforts to be able to come up with the money to be able to put into these projects. Because when you build a new house, you know, there are certain regulations and rules you have to follow, certain materials you have to use. But when you're doing historical preservation and historical restoration, there are a lot more rules and regulations, and you have to stay as close to the original as possible to be that building and restore that building to its original luster and what it originally was.
What does the Maine community have to look forward to when the restoration is complete?
Sure. So I think what's really important about the Abyssinian is that it's a place of, is that it's Black history come alive. And so I think when people read history or read history books, you can imagine things, but the Abyssinian is where history happened. You can go in there and you can see where all these speakers spoke or where these children were educated or where services were. And it's a physical relic of history, and you can go in there and you can feel it and you can see it, and it's real and it's tangible. And I think bringing Black history alive in particular in a place like Maine is so critically important. And I think that's being able to continue to tell our story, both of Black history in Maine and the history of Maine, because it's frequently said every month is Black History Month at the Abyssinian.
What are you most excited about for the future of the AMH?
Yeah, I think it goes back to what my previous answer. I'm just excited to, one, you know, complete this project that a team of really dedicated people have put decades into, because they care so much about what the history is and sharing that with people, because storytelling is so critical. And I mean, as you know, you're a storyteller yourself, being able to communicate our history and to be able to share that with other people is what's so important. And again, to be able to have this physical relic of history and physical relic of storytelling, I think is really important and really exciting.
How can people support these efforts? Is there anything that kids can do?
Sure, there's a lot that people can do. Especially kids. I'll plug, no donation is too small. There have been bake sales that kids have done. There have been food drives. There are lots of things that kids can do to raise money. Again, no donation is too small. But I think what's really important is to share knowledge and to share learning. And so what kids can do and what anybody can do is learn about the Abyssinian, learn about Black history, go and visit the building if you can. And then to tell people about it, to tell your friends, to tell your parents, to tell your community, because knowledge sharing and storytelling is how all of the knowledge gets shared with each other.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Anisa. It was so exciting learning more about such an important part of Maine's history. My name is Ellie with WCTM.